At the Evening of Honors, our most prestigious award is the Medal of Honor. This year, we are very excited to be giving it to Billy Hoglan and the employees of Hoglan Group LLC. They employ more than 1,000 people throughout the country, including more than 600 on Long Island. Billy and his employees are committed to our community, to the region, to making it a better place to live, to work, to do business and raise a family. Long Island has the opportunity to be the offshore wind capital of the country, and Hoglan Group is going to be instrumental in that effort. They're already the prime contractor on the South Fork Wind Project, which is the first offshore wind project in New York State. They were recently awarded the contract for Sunrise Wind, another major offshore wind farm that's going to be built off the coast of Long Island. And Hoglan Group is at the forefront of this emerging industry that's positioning Long Island to create more clean energy jobs, to help combat climate change, and to be a leader in renewable energy production. And I'm personally really happy to be honoring Billy tonight. Billy is a great guy. He's not only a colleague now on our board of directors, but I consider him a real friend. He's a wonderful person with a big heart. He's got a lot of employees that work hard for him, that are committed to his mission of doing better for our community, doing right by our community. And the Hoglan Group is a model corporate citizen that does a lot for Long Island, does a lot for the business community, and we're really excited to be honoring them with the award tonight.
Tonight I'm pleased to award the Harry Chapin Humanitarian Award, one of the longest standing awards the LIA has given, to the co-directors of the Cinema Arts Center, Charlotte Sky and Dylan Skolnick, and their employees for their many years of bringing new and exciting ideas to Long Island. The Cinema Arts Center is extremely important in bringing in new films, historical films, and other ideas as a venue for people on Long Island to come together and discuss them and experience them, as opposed to many times what we do is look at our screens by ourselves. With our good friend and supporter, Sandy Chapin, I am delighted that we are giving this award to Charlotte and Dylan. Tonight, I have the distinct honor of presenting Henry Holley for his Lifetime Achievement Award for the LIA. I've been on the LIA board for over 25 years, and my earliest memories of coming to meetings was Henry Holley was there. He was already there. He was already well known for his transportation company on Long Island. He was a contributor. And he still comes to the LIA meetings and he's still a contributor all these many years later. I'm just pleased that I could present this award to Henry. He's been part of the fabric of the LIA, part of the DNA, and I hope he stays with us for many years to come.
This year is the first year we're giving out the Key to the Island Award. It's meant to honor somebody that maybe wasn't born on Long Island or grew up on Long Island, but we've adopted that person and now they're a Long Islander through and through. And it gives me great pleasure that tonight the first Key to the Island Award is going to John Ledecky, who's the co-owner of the New York Islanders in the NHL and the Bridgeport Islanders in the AHL. And one of the best things about John is he's just a regular guy. He's a man of the people. He's very accessible. He's very approachable. And even though he's this very successful business person, he gets it about giving back to the community, about trying to do what's best for Long Island. And we are very fortunate to have John and the Islanders involved with the LIA, especially through Mike Constantino, who's one of their executive vice presidents, sits on our board, terrific guy. We should all be grateful for John Ledecky. You know, but for John, the Islanders would probably be playing in Kansas City or Canada or somewhere else, but I know they wouldn't be on Long Island. He made sure that the Islanders stayed here. He built a brand new arena, UBS Arena in Elmont. It's state of the art, it's beautiful. It's a terrific home for the New York Islanders, and I'm just so happy to be honoring him with this Key to the Island Award tonight.